And what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Daily Pfav. This is episode 177 for Monday, June 3rd, 2019. It's 8:52 p.m. here on the East Coast. And my, what a busy couple weeks have flown by for me. First and most importantly, my mother is home and out of the hospital, which is fantastic news, and she is doing great getting reacclimated back into the home setting after being in the hospital for a very scary several weeks. So that is great to have her back home and in good spirits and in good health. The second thing, and I don't know if I've talked about this yet here on the Daily Pfav, but I've launched my fourth podcast. It's called the KEMA Podcast, and that's for the Keystone Emergency Management Association. And for those of you that know me or follow me on social media, you know that I am heavily involved with emergency management. And so to be able to do an emergency management podcast for a state emergency management association has been absolutely great. We're 11 episodes in. And again, you can find it all at paulfalavolitopodcast.com. And speaking of that website, it's all new. Gelman totally redid the whole website, so you can find all of my content there. It's easier than ever to find it. It's just gorgeous the way that he laid this new podcasting website out for me. It's fantastic. I just finished, if you've listened to my last couple 7-minute leadership podcasts, I had mentioned that this past Saturday I was hosting my second annual leadership summit for my management staff. And so that just happened this past Saturday, and what a great event that was. That was a 5-hour deal down at Dave and Buster's at the waterfront. They donated a private room to us for us to be able to have this event. Had some great presentations that we did, some great strategic discussions about everything dealing with our ambulance service, and it was just a fantastic idea. And kind of the message, the leadership message that I wanted to leave with my people is, don't worry about being in charge, worry about making an impact. And that's a big deal in the leadership world, because I think that too many people in management and leadership positions worry about the title and worry about the power and worry about being in charge rather than truly making an impact on the people that they're tasked with leading and making an impact for the company. So I kind of built Summit 2019 all around that concept, and I think it was fantastic. And I want to do another one. I want to do one publicly for people to attend. I'd love to travel with this idea of doing them. And so I kind of put a call to action out and asked if anybody would attend if I did one to the public here in Pittsburgh or if I took it on the road. And I have gotten some feedback sent into me, so that's been kind of fun to read that. Some more exciting news, at least for me, and hopefully for the people that follow me on social media. It has literally been about 3 months since I picked up my camera, which is unheard of, and had the opportunity on Sunday to go to the Pittsburgh Zoo. Kind of ran around the zoo for 2 hours, took a little north of 600 plus pictures, and in the end I found 36 that I loved, and I've already posted two of them on Facebook and Instagram. So if you follow me there, you've seen them, and if you haven't yet, follow me and then you can see them as well. I think they turned out spectacular. They're some of my favorite animal pictures I think I've ever taken. And, that was kind of a bear of a project because I took the biggest lens that I own. It's my, I think it's a 200 to 500 millimeter zoom lens. This thing probably weighs 6 or 8 pounds. And, it was a big deal trying to carry that around all day to take pictures, but I'm in love with them and I'm going to be posting them here all throughout this week. And tomorrow I will be attending the Ohio Tactical Officers Association conference. I think it's the second largest Tactical Officers Association conference in the United States behind the National Tactical Officers Association conference. And there's going to be a lot of SWAT police, a lot of tactical EMS people there. So I need to get up there and make my presence known, meet some people, get some business cards, check out the vendors and all the equipment, build bridges, make connections, do all that stuff, and hopefully bring something good back here to our tactical EMS team, because I know in about a week we have our next big tactical EMS drill is coming up in conjunction with our police departments. And something magical happened today, and if you follow me on Twitter, I'm not sure if you can follow the conversation, but all I can tell you now is someone reached out to me, someone else with a blue check mark besides me contacted me, and I did a little interview with them, and hopefully you're going to see that on national television here at some point this week, but I'm not going to give away too much about it until it happens and until it airs, and then I'll make a big deal about it and publicize it everywhere. So that was kind of a fun surprise, like, you know, who wakes up in the morning thinking that's going to fall in your lap during your day? But nevertheless, it did, and it's just been a very kind of a cool, exciting day for me, and a busy, busy week coming up as well. So I just wanted to get on, do another one of these episodes, and keep everyone up to date with everyone, with everything that's going on. So again, if you haven't checked out my new website, PaulFalavolitoPodcast.com, it's fantastic. I owe all the design and creative effort to Josh Gelman. He really knocked it out of the park for me. And if you've missed any of the latest EMS Talk 7-Minute Leaderships, and if you want to check out the new KEMA Podcast, that show's just a lot of fun, and I hope you will check that out. So I'm going to drop it right there for tonight. 412-701-4323. Oh, and Roxy's calling me because it's pepperoni time. 412-701-4323 is the show call-in number. PaulFalavolitoPodcast.com. Thanks for listening.